So you've seen them. I've seen them. They're everywhere. Hiring now signs, help wanted signs. Everybody seems to be hiring, but where are all the workers? We'll cover that in this episode of the Seven Figure Squad, happening in 3, 2, 1, let's go.
Never short stopping, now I'm winning like I'm Jeter. Steady through the rigor, yeah, I'm getting bigger. Just fighting in them trenches, now I'm making seven figures like.
What's cracking, everybody? Money Smart Guy Matt Sapaula here, hailing to you from Oak Brook Terrace, Illinois, a direct west suburb of downtown Chicago. And in today's episode, I want to share with you my reaction to the job shortage, labor shortage that was reported earlier this month. In the past couple weeks, I've been honored to be an invited guest on News Nation Now. We've covered a range of topics from NFTs to unemployment to spiking inflation. So they asked me, Matt, Money Smart Guy, what is your opinion on the surprising job shortage, labor shortage numbers in spite of all the trillions of dollars that have been pumped and printed into our economy the last 12 to 18 months? Let's check this out.
And now we want to bring in Matt Sapaula, otherwise known as the Money Guy, to talk more about this outlook on unemployment. Good to have you back. Thanks for your time tonight. What was your main takeaway from the report? Trying to get a sense of kind of what industries are up and which ones obviously fell way short of expectations here.
Oh, sure. You know, if you're looking at the industries most affected by COVID, it was the airline industry, leisure, hospitality, auto parts and equipment were down, most affected. Restaurants were down. Now that we're seeing these jobs come up, to see that leisure and hospitality industry up 331,000 jobs, it's good to see that. But, you know, I was just having dinner. You know, so oftentimes you see these numbers and common sense sometimes has a way to creeping in. Went to a restaurant the other day and we were looking for servers to service. I mean, it was a well-to-do type of restaurant. And the manager says, we just can't find servers to work with us.
Well, I know there's this debate going on right now. It's the shortage of jobs or shortage of workers, kind of which way does it go? How do you see that?
You know, I'm looking at the data. If we looked on the unemployment website, it's do I want a boss or do I deal with my unemployment benefits? Because the maximum benefits for a single person, which equates to about $3,136 per month. And if you have those unemployment benefits, that's equivalent to about $18 an hour. Now, if you are with dependents, that goes up to $3,876 a month. That equates to about $22 an hour. So people just might be waiting on the sideline and say, you know what? Let me wait for the next opportunity to come in. If it's not paying me more than this for the time being, let me wait on taking a job. Because it's only a few months or a month ago that we saw so many people traveling for spring break. People want to get out. People want to connect. People want to socialize. But to go back to work, they're taking a quick pause at it.
Right. And that's a talking point on the right, that people rather get their unemployment benefits than look for work. And there's a lot of debate. I was reading an analysis today that suggested that obviously this has been a life-altering event. And some people are just thinking about how and when they want to go back. Childcare is still tough. Schools are not open. They want something different than the job they had before. It's a very complicated dynamic. It certainly is not as simple as seeing, well, I'm getting my check now, I'm not going back to work. Post-COVID-19 life is a little more complicated than that, right?
Yeah, and I think sometimes people do. There's a safety concern. You know, people aren't getting the vaccine. You know, that's a safety concern. Do I want to go back around people and bring that back home to my elderly parents if people aren't getting vaccinated? And we have this lack of getting this herd immunity up to what the, it was, 88%, 89% getting up to the herd immunity type status if people aren't getting the vaccine. You know, so there's some concerns there too as well. I just heard Papa John saying, hey, listen, but we got 10,000 jobs willing to offer today. Please apply at Papa John's. Nobody is coming in though.
And some good news, some highlights in there. Air travel, certainly back up. Spending at restaurants, hotels, and bars, that's looking up. New unemployment claims are falling. That's certainly good news. Read some Wall Street analysis today that kind of said this is more of an anomaly, a weird month, because all the general signs are pretty positive. The bigger picture's okay. It's just that April, 1 month, fell way short. Do you think that's true?
A couple of data points. There's 750,000 labor force numbers, jobs are back up. So 750,000 jobs are back up in terms of inclusion to the labor force. And also the capacity for people to say, you know what, this might be an opportunity for the main numbers to show the result that people were expecting in April. So that number we'll pay attention to as the weeks go by and a new month comes up.
And we lost 22 million jobs in the course of the pandemic, and we're still about eight in the hole. Realistically, what do you think the time frame is for when we're not made whole or fully back, but when we things feel far different than they do today, you think by the end of the year?
I think mid-year. I think we're seeing right now, like here in Chicago, the festivals are open back up again. Chicago wants to be fully open. I think July is when Las Vegas is going to be 75% open again. We're having a company convention in August there at the MGM Grand Arena. So there's a lot of things that are looking very exciting as the summer months roll up. And if this whole thing about COVID does not affect a lot of people during summer because people got vitamin D now, the sun's out, it's warm, we'll see how that translates here in the summertime. But I expect to see lots of people want to get back, want to connect. I think the confidence is skyrocketing. A fear is starting to subside. Our people are starting to educate and understand this outbreak, this pandemic a little bit better. And I think people are boosting their immune system and hopefully taking better care of their bodies.
It's a big hole that COVID left us, and it will be a slow climb out of it. So, but certainly some encouraging signs out there. All right. Thank you, sir. Appreciate your time as always.
Thanks for having me as always.
You see, we talked about this in a previous reaction video I had to the stimulus plan, or in this case, stimulus plans. Do I think people needed help during this pandemic? Absolutely. Did it provide an immediate relief to people? Sure. But creating a indirect incentive for people to remain unemployed, even when federal benefits run out here in September, it will be interesting to see how things play out over the long term. I mean, who would ever thought that an employer's competition, as competitive as a business community is, I mean, who would ever thought that the business owner's competitors would be the government payroll? And to those saying that, Matt, we need to raise the minimum wage to $15 an hour, please subscribe to this video and see why that wouldn't make a difference, much of a difference for that matter, anyway. In this other video here, check out a reaction I had to Mark Cuban's advice to getting rich and making money work for you, in my two cents on getting control of your money. That being said, I want to know your thoughts. What are your questions? What are your follow-ups? What's your feedback? You agree with me? You not agree with me? Drop them in the comments section below. That being said, guys, if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page, Money Smart Guy. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe and hit notifications to be alerted the next time we upload our next episode. That being said, I'm your Money Smart Guy, and until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.